So let's talk about Pythagorean identity. Okay, and guys, there are three Pythagorean identities. They are right here. If you take out your formula sheet, right here. Right? Pythagorean identities. First one being what? Sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. Second one, tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared. Last one, 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. Okay? So in this question here, we're gonna try to use the unit circle to prove the first Pythagorean identity. Cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1. How do you do that? Guys, remember what unit circle is? We talked about unit circle in the previous section, right? Unit circle, nothing crazy. Look. Unit circle is just a circle with radius unit. Unit means the radius must equal 1, right? Okay. And guys, let's call this point on the circle x and y. So x coordinate being x, y coordinate being y. Okay? And guys, from this point, let's draw a perpendicular line to the x-axis. Okay, so guys, I want you to focus on this triangle. By the way, what do we call this angle? The angle between the terminal arm and x-axis, we call this angle what? The reference angle, right? Which is the most important angle we consider in trigonometry. Reference angle. Okay, so guys, so in this triangle here, look, if x coordinate is x, that means what? That means the length for the x segment would be what? Would be x, right? Mm-hmm. Now, if the y coordinate is y, that means the length of the vertical segment for the triangle will be y, right? Mm-hmm. It's nothing crazy, right? It's like this. So, for example, let's say if I have a point here, I call it 3 and 5. That means what? That means if I draw a triangle, 3 means x coordinate 3, that means what? 1, 2, 3, right? So that means the length of this segment would be 3, right? Now if the y coordinate is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means what? The length of the vertical segment here must be 5, right? Same thing. If the x coordinate is x, that means what? That means this portion of the triangle, the horizontal portion of the triangle will be x. If the y coordinate is y, that means the vertical portion of the triangle will just be what? Length will just be y, right? Same thing as that. Okay? Yeah. So x represents the x segment. Y represents the y segment, right? Cool. So now, hey guys, I want you to focus on this triangle right here. Right? So let's apply Pythagoras. What's Pythagoras? Pythagoras tells us x squared plus y squared equals to the hypotenuse squared. So we have x squared plus y squared equals what? The hypotenuse squared. So hypotenuse in this case is 1, right? Because it's a unit circle. So it equals 1 squared. Right? Cool. But guys, do you also remember one thing? For a unit circle, if you forget, you can always go back to the notes or the videos from the previous section when we talk about unit circle. For a unit circle, x coordinate can also be represented as what? In terms of the angle theta, x coordinate can be represented as cosine theta, right? And for a unit circle, y coordinate can be represented as what? Something in terms of the angle. That'll be sine theta, right? Remember that? For a unit circle and unit circle only, right? So for any point on the circle, x coordinate can be represented as cosine theta. Y coordinate can be represented as sine theta. So guys, check this out. 1 squared is just 1. Because now look. X coordinate can be represented as what? Cosine theta. So x coordinate represented as cosine theta. Now y coordinate can be represented as what? Sine theta. So y coordinate can be represented as sine theta. Ah! Guess what? Guys, we're done. From the unit circle, we successfully proved that cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1. Then we're done. Right? But guys, from this formula, cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1, we can actually derive the other two Pythagorean identities, right? Which is this. See guys, just now we successfully proved that cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1. And guys, guess what? We can actually use this guy, the result of this guy, to prove what? To prove the second Pythagorean identity as well as the third Pythagorean identity. How do we do that? So how do we prove tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared? Okay? So now let's do that. Let's do it right here. Okay guys, from this guy here. From sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1, that's what we just proved earlier, right? Now, from this guy, let's try to derive the second Pythagorean identity. And this is what I do, guys. Check this out. I go, everybody multiply by 1 over cosine squared. And let's see what happened. So guys, multiply 1 over cosine squared into the first guy in the bracket, we have what? We have 1 over cosine squared times sine squared, we have sine squared over cosine squared, right? Now, multiply this guy into the second item inside the bracket. 1 over cosine squared times cosine squared. Well, we have what? We have cosine squared over cosine squared, right? Can you see that? 1 over cosine squared times cosine squared. We have cosine squared over cosine squared. And here. Now, multiply 1 over cosine squared into the last guy in the bracket. 1 over cosine squared times 1, well, it's just 1 over cosine squared. Right? And guys, now, guys, what's sine over cosine? According to the quotient identity, sine over cosine is tangent, right? Sine over cosine is tangent. Then sine squared over cosine squared will just be tangent squared. Right? And now, here, the second term here, cosine squared over cosine squared, well, cancels out, that's just 1. And guys, according to the reciprocal identity, 1 over cosine is what? 1 over cosine is secant. Right? Then 1 squared over cosine squared would just be secant squared. Guys, what do you see here? Oh. What did we just come up with? Tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared. Check this out. Tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared. Just like that. Right? Just like that. We successfully proved the second Pythagorean identity. Right? Now, how do we prove the last Pythagorean identity? Check this out. Easy. Very similar. But now, instead of multiplying by 1 over cosine squared, let's multiply by 1 over sine squared and see what we come up with. Okay, so guys, multiply this guy into the first item in the bracket. 1 over sine squared times sine squared, we get sine squared over sine squared, right? Plus. Now multiply this guy into the second item in the bracket. We have cosine squared on top, sine squared on the bottom. Now multiply this guy into the last item inside the bracket. We just have 1 over sine squared, right? So now, guys, sine squared cancels out. We have 1. Now here it is. Guys, what's cosine over sine? According to the quotient identity, cosine over sine is cotangent. It's cotangent, right? Then cosine squared over sine squared would be what? Cotangent squared. Okay? Now, what's 1 over sine? According to the reciprocal identity, 1 over sine is cosecant. Oops. 1 over sine is cosecant, right? Then 1 squared over sine squared would be cosecant squared. Ah, guys, look at what we just came up with. 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. Isn't that this guy right here? 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. So guys, so like I said, we used a unit circle to prove the first Pythagorean identity. And once we have that, it's very easy to derive the other two Pythagorean identities from the first one. Okay? That's it.